I've been watching you guys all week long, all summer long. You did a great job on the highlights, the countdown. You guys do a great job, you and Jimmy and Charlotte.
Thanks, it's been fun. 2:44 to go here in quarter number two. Pitch back to Matt Cashman.
He gets
an edge in. Finds a hole and Cashman is gone. No one's going to get him across the 50 down to the 40.
I don't know. I think we got it.
Dragged down by Brandon Cole. Otherwise, he was taking that one to the house.
I'll tell you, a heck of a play by Cole, though. That's the way to hustle. That's what you're trying to get from your team. You know, the score is 27-7, but boy, you ran him down. Nice little toss play. Again, watch this crack. This is how you draw it up on the board. This is not the Lombardi sweep, but a version of it. Little toss play, and those outside receivers did a nice job, especially Pecorelli on the outside. Watch this. There's that seam right there. Watch Pecorelli's block on the outside right there. Frees him up, and Cashman is open at daylight. But again, great job by Cole. That's a hustle play right there.
Great job by Cashman running to that pylon.
Yeah, great job, though. Great job. You want to see a young man hustle, and you're seeing that tonight from the Crestwood Comets.
A big gain down to the 18-yard line. First and 10 for Berwick. C.J. Curry under center. Fakes the handoff around the left side and gets hit, but keeps going, keeps the momentum going, and out of bounds near the 7-yard line for C.J. Curry.
Yeah, they came to this play. They scored a touchdown before in the right corner. And again, Coach Curry's famous for running that play. He loves to run it into his bench. That's where he's kind of has a little bit of edge with the officials, but it's just a little midline option. Dive up inside. They cave that outside, create a little bit of perimeter action, and then C.J. just takes it off the corner. He's a pretty tough kid. So many better wheels than I thought he had. Doesn't like running like his grandfather. We know that for sure. Look at that. He looks ready. He's going to a bodybuilding contest.
So ball on the 8-yard line for Berwick. Going in for another score. Cashman off that left side. Stood up. Helmet goes flying off, and they will mark this one at the 4.
Again, another version of the trap game. This time he led with his tight end, number 99. That's Wodashek, whose dad was a great athlete for him. So George is showing me a lot of things tonight. I'm surprised he's showing this much this early. Either number one, he's trying to get himself in a position to be able to run his offense, or he wants Coach Keating to have as much film as he can possibly see to digest for next week's game. So he's running the same basic play, Steve. We talked about that in the outset of the show. His staple plays are maybe 5 or 6, but his formation differentials are so much that it appears to be different plays time after time.
So the game clock starts up, 1:32 to go. Berwick on the 4. Hand off to the motion guy, Jake Pecorelli, using that speed, and he is in for the touchdown.
I'll tell you right now, again, great block by Ladonis on the outside, number 3. When you run speed sweep and you get that kind of caving on the outside of what we call perimeter barriers, they're just forcing that edge, they're controlling that edge. When you're outside receivers, it looks like you actually pancaked the Crestwood kid on this play. Great job by the young man, just a junior or sophomore, number 3. He made that play go.